Dr. Sylvie?
Yes, ma'am.
How are you? How's everybody?
Fine. Who's on the line?
Michelle.
Yeah, all right.
Roll call, we'll find out.
Okay, I'm on now.
Very well.
Okay.
Thank you.
Can we start the meeting now?
Yes, sir.
All right. The meeting is being called to order at this time. May we have the roll call, please?
Yes, Marturio Martinez.
Present.
Jackie Ramos.
Present.
Henry Carranza, present. Cynthia Maris.
Yes, again, I'm sorry, I disconnected by mistake, sorry.
But you're here. Jorge Delgado.
Present.
Lupita Cepeda. Esteban Rangel. Michelle de la Peña.
Present.
Tita Cantu.
Here.
Mr. President, you have a quorum.
We have a quorum. Thank you very much. This, for your information, okay, this meeting is strictly for us being informed by the administration and specifically by Dr. Solis. There are no action is being requested at the present time by any member where actual votes are going to be addressed, okay? So this is no specific situation other than informing the board of situations dealing with the college itself. I know that there has been some concern by a number of students as well as probably other faculty members. So at the present time, no action is okay. Being requested for actual motion and voting on that specific situation, okay? Dr. Solis, you have the floor, sir.
Sir, may we proceed with agenda, sir? Please proceed with agenda. May we proceed with agenda, sir?
Oh, okay, we're proceeding with the agenda. There's no public comments at the present time. No one has actually come before us at the present time. So that was item number three. Item number four is general updates on the altered college operations during the COVID-19 event. Dr. Solis, you have the floor, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much, Judge. Yes, we appreciate you all taking the time in these very trying times right now. We have, as I have been informing you throughout the past 2 weeks, we have been taking all the measures possible. We continue with our daily phone conferences with the Laredo Emergency Group, as well as our daily meetings with the Texas Higher Education Board, as well as with the Texas Association of Community Colleges. So this whole situation continues moving every day. There's a lot of still unanswered questions and unknowns, but again, we are focusing mainly on two areas, which is, of course, the health and safety of all employees and especially our students. And number two, we are also taking the consideration measures to making sure our financial stability is intact. With that said, we have a couple of items that we would like to update the board. And I have Dr. Fred, who's going to updating on some ideas that we have in regarding to fees. Dr. Fred.
This is Lupita Cepeda, join the call.
Okay. Good afternoon.
Hi, Lupita.
Ladies and gentlemen of the board, Fred Solis, Vice President for Student Success and Enrollment. Due to the onset of COVID-19 in our community, the college has altered its instructional delivery. As of Monday, March 30th, all instruction that was offered face-to-face has transitioned into an online format. Students both on campus and off campus, including dual credit, have been attending their courses online. As the official withdrawal date for the spring semester approaches, April the 9th, the college has taken measures to ensure that students who drop classes for the spring semester 2020 after spring break will not be charged the $10 add drop processing fee. Moreover, with the standing rules related to COVID-19 for shelter in place, social distancing and community gatherings, and the likelihood that these rules are not going to be rescinded in the near future, administration has decided that in the best interest of all students, the upcoming sessions of Maymester, Summer Session 1, Summer Session 2, 2020, will include only online courses. As such, the administration has decided not to charge the distance learning fee of $20 per semester credit hour and the parking street maintenance fee of $10 per student. Should the conditions related to COVID-19 improve, administration may consider face-to-face courses during the summer. At this time, the fall 2020 schedule is planned with a combination of face-to-face and online instruction. That is my report.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, I want to reemphasize the observation that has been made by Dr. Solis in this case. The classes will be strictly online, no actual presence in classrooms whatsoever. This is what is being addressed by Dr. Solis. Any other comments or observations from any member of the board? By the way, let the record reflect that Ms. Lupita Cepeda called in, so she's listening in on the phone. Any observations or comments? Dr. Ricardo Solis?
At this time, I think that was really the only item we wanted to bring up as right now a procedure that we're doing that would alleviate the situation and help the students especially. And with that said, I think that's all I have for this meeting. And 1 second. Yeah, I would, one other update, of course, as I mentioned to you last week, the only program that right now we continue operating, instructional program, is a police academy in the South Campus. And I mentioned that that's the only one that we have, and we're taking all the precautions by dividing the students in several classrooms, and we are accelerating this program because of the high demand and pressure that we're obtaining to graduate these cadets as soon as possible. We estimate that by the end of this month, before the end of this month, they will be completed and graduated and ready to go into the workforce. I wanted to emphasize that that's the only program there right now we're operating in the South, in both campuses.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ricardo Solis. Yes. Any observation or comment from any member of the board at the present time?
None.
Okay. Anything else?
No.
That being the case, I'd like to hear a motion for adjournment.
So move.
Sir, we go to
executive session.
Yes, we are. We're going to go into executive session, and that is item number 5. I rescind my observation for adjournment at this time. The item number 5 is discussion of certain non-instructional Laredo College programs and related personnel, including legal matters pursuant to Texas Government Code Sections 551.071 and 551.074. I'd like to hear a motion that we go into executive session at this time.
So move, sir.
Second. We have a motion.
I second.
We have a second. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 All right. Okay. We go into executive session right now. Thank you very much.
12:10, sir.
It's very fashionable. Dr. Solis has one, why can't I?
We are rolling, okay.
Yeah, but we have to wait for those that are on the phone.
Yes. Yeah. Just so you know that we're being live streamed right now on
Facebook, so they're observing, and you can listen as well. So, we're live.
Okay. We're all now connected. We're now all connected. At this time, we are back in public session on our meeting. No action was taken whatsoever. We go into item number six, and that is to address certain non-instructional Laredo College programs and related personnel. Dr. Solis, you have the floor.
Thank you, Judge. I think we, at this point, we're going to take into consideration the suggestions and insights brought up by the board, and we will do some more further analysis of programmatic functions and costs, and assemble that for you to analyze, and then provide a discussion and decision in the very near future.
Okay. These questions that were asked in executive session, Dr. Solis will address, as well as Dr. Rodriguez, since it presented major concern by some members of the board. With that being in mind, do we have any other observation or comments to be brought before this meeting is adjourned?
Sir, no action on number six, sir.
I'm sorry?
No action on number six.
No action on number six. That is correct. This addressed the discussion of certain non-instructional Laredo College programs and related personnel, including legal matters. There was no action whatsoever. That being the case, do we have a motion for adjournment?
So moved.
We have a second? All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All right, we stand adjourned. It is 12:50, and we are now adjourned. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and those of you that are on the phone, thank you very much.
Everybody stay safe.
Thank you.